This video goes over Eigen's impulse response rendering mode. Previous video goes over Eigen's general play functionality as well as all the generic controls, so you should probably watch that first if you haven't. Arguably the main feature of Eigen, using the same settings for calculating early reflections, in play mode, you can also use the controls along with a few more to render high quality impulse responses that you can either use directly in Eigen or export as WAV files for use in other convolution reverbs. The main controls are found here. The Use High Quality Materials toggle changes if the materials dampen the sound reflections in a way that involves splitting up the audio into multiple bands for higher accuracy, or if the materials just use a simplified wideband processing system. The Render Reverb Tail toggle sets if we are computing late reflections along with early reflections. And the Early Reflection Depth control adjusts the offline rendering reflection depth. In play mode, the depth is set by the control below, but in render mode, the depth is set here. The difference being that we can compute reflections up to 40 bounces deep, as opposed to play mode's depth of 7. A depth of 40 reflections results in about 25,000 different reflections being computed, as the number of possible reflection possibilities goes up exponentially as the depth increases. In terms of rendering, the propagate and normalize controls that were went over in the play mode overview video also apply to impulse response rendering. When propagate is turned off, there is no initial pre-delay that occurs in the rendered audio file. And the normalize control will change whether or not your impulse response is adjusted to have a 0 decibel peak. When an impulse response is available, the convolution button is enabled, and this lets us toggle between play mode's basic early reflection simulation and using the impulse response with Eigen's own internal convolution reverb. Let's render a few more impulse responses with different settings to see how they sound. We'll be using the same positioning, material, and dimension settings, but with different render controls. When an impulse response is rendered, you can preview how it sounds by pressing the play button here. In this case, this one is rendered with a high early reflection depth, but without the reverb tail. This one is rendered with the same settings as before, but it also has the reverb tail. This one is rendered with the reverb tail, but with a low reflection depth. And this one is rendered with the low reflection depth, no reverb tail, and in this case, the high quality materials have also been turned off. When we render an impulse response, we get the waveform render, but we also get this view as well. What this is an average representation of the impulse response's spectral content, so we can judge how much volume is present in different sections of the audio spectrum. If you want to save an impulse response, all you need to do is press the save icon next to the play button, and your file chooser dialog based on whatever operating system you're using will open up. Let's also have a quick look at the analysis tab, as it is much less involved than the other modes. All that the analysis does is let you analyze your space's computed room modes, which are essentially measurements of how your sound's lower frequencies will resonate against the acoustic space. We have a more in-depth article about this available on the Lese website. Changing the dimensions of the space, the materials on the walls, and the positioning of the sound source and listener will adjust how the room mode graph looks. This is helpful mostly for people trying to understand how their space simulations will sound in the lower frequencies, but could also be used as a basic analysis tool for people trying to predict acoustics of real spaces. Thank you.